Hello everyone, I'm Cindy Cowan, and we have some exciting news. You heard it here first. Omnicultural TV Fest is coming December 8th. It's gonna be an all-day event populated by your very own avatar for a superb network experience. This week, we are showcasing one of our selections, an animation by Gladys Studios out of Puerto Rico. Phantomville is about an adventurous kid who is new in town. He befriends some peculiar ghosts and helps them with their unfinished business. With actors Esteban Ruiz and Eric Rodriguez, art director Yamil Medina, and producer Nicole Betancourt. Kiki Melendez.
We're doing it! Yeah! Let's go! Let's go! Let's do it! Let's do it! Esteban, you just move your head, that's all, right? Are you a good dancer, Esteban?
No, I'm not a good dancer. Those are my moves on a dance floor. It would have been the same.
All the way from Puerto Rico! This is so cool to see such talent coming out of Puerto Rico. We have one of our official selections for Omnicultural TV Fest, Phantomville.
Thank you.
This is an awesome project. Thank you so much for submitting it to Omni. We're very honored to showcase it at our festival in partnership with NATPE, the National Association of Television Program Executives. It is a five-star festival, people. Okay, it's no joke.
Thank you.
Last year,
thank you for having us.
Eight projects in the festival. So we have what we do is we try to show the world how much talent there is out there with emerging producers and people that are making their own stories. So tell me, who was the brain behind Phantomville, and how did it come up?
Well, Phantomville actually is not a one-person idea. We as a group, we sit together and we come up with some problem that is having in the world. And one of the problems is like judging a book by his cover. Us Latinos, Puerto Rican, if we go outside, they confuse us with other nationalities. And how better way to explain it with kids to have multicultural kids in the neighborhood, plus ghosts that in the first thing in your mind, you think they're evil and they're bad. But once you know them, you know that they just only need to find their way. And that's what the kids are doing. They're helping each other and they're helping the ghosts to find their way. And that's how we come up with the idea of making Phantomville.
Awesome. It's beautiful. I love it. It's all multicultural, right? You know, so yeah. Is the neighborhood supposed, where is the neighborhood of Phantomville? Is it in Puerto Rico? Is it in New York? Where is it?
We based it in Florida, actually.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I felt so familiar. I grew up in Florida, so I was like, I feel like I've seen this place before.
Yeah, but the main character is from Puerto Rico, and he moved from Puerto Rico to Florida, and he be like all his world and his environment changed completely. And he's trying to look for himself and everything.
So Eric, tell me a little bit about your background.
Well, the great thing about this is that Esteban, Yamil, and I, we've been friends for quite a while. And I've been doing improv for 25 years now, and I've been in show business for almost that same time. And I've been doing movies in Puerto Rico. I'm very popular here as part of the pop culture, underground pop culture here. They call me Chicho because of one of the characters from one of the movies I've been at. And the funny thing is that I went for casting when they were trying to find the voice for some of the characters. And I took my girlfriend there. And even though I know them, I never asked them, you know, for a part. I was there and they told me, you know, wow, you know, we know you, you do this, you know, you should cast for this. And I did Reggie and I just, I don't know. I think it's me, you know, Reggie. If you see Reggie,
and you see me, that's you.
There's a resemblance, and Reggie was already drawn, you know, thought of right. as a chef. You know, I love cooking.
Wait, Reggie doesn't have a beard.
That's the only thing he doesn't have.
One of the we have to distinguish them. Like we can have them be completely the same. So we went sans beard.
And you, Esteban, you're also an actor. What have you been in before? What?
Like Eric, I'm also an improviser, and he's actually been one of my main teachers doing improv and acting. And ever since around 2016, I've worked in various movies and series in Puerto Rico, as well as one of the first series that I did was a web series called La Agencia, or The Agency, which was about an artist agency where they do commercial art. And I was a writer as well as an actor on that. So that was my first job as a writer and one of my first jobs as an actor. And I've been doing that ever since with sketches or short films. And this was a chance that when Jamil was working on the first stages of Phantom Build, he brought me in to help develop even more ideas. And I've been working ever since on Phantom Build and other writing jobs within Gladius. The full info about Eric is that on that initial interview, he wasn't gonna audition. His girlfriend was gonna audition, and we made him audition, and we gave him a job instead of her.
I'm sure yeah. that's a lot for the relationship.
But in later stages, we did end up hiring her also when a better character came along for her talent. So it worked out. It you just took a little longer.
You saved it.
Yeah.
So Nicole, tell me a little bit about Gladius Studio and how you're involved with all these crazy nuts.
Yes, well, I'm the business development director there, and Gladius is a big family. We are an animation and emerging technology studio, so we have native projects like Phantom Mill, and we have the client division. So there we do projects or VR experiences and animations for many brands as well.
How is business in Puerto Rico as far as production and filmmaking? How is it going down there?
It's been pretty busy the last 2 to 3 years. After Hurricane Maria, yeah. we had like many projects. We were working like 16 projects at a time. At the same time, so it was really overwhelming, but it was great. It helped us really much. And we have since December of last year, we have doubled our employment, our employees there.
Wow.
So it's been really nice. It hasn't been a difficulty working from home. So win-win. We've been working with all the projects as well, nonstop. So we are really proud of that.
And how are you all handling the pandemic down there? Are you guys like us here in California, where we can't do anything unless it's outdoors and, you know, social distancing, masks?
Yes.
Are you guys, I heard Puerto Rico was even more strict than the United States. Is that correct?
Yep.
Yes, right now, yes, it is.
What is more strict than us? What are you guys doing that is a little more strict?
It's only the essential things that can be done. So if the work can be done remotely, you have to do it that way. Right. If you have to go to the office or to any other place to work, you have to justify and you have to be maybe of the health area, have right. a sub-production.
Now, so, are you letting people into Puerto Rico? I heard that there was something like they weren't letting, you know, extranjeros or people from other countries come in.
They're actually letting them in, but you have to go through certain paperwork before getting to the island, like mm-hmm. having been COVID tested and bringing it in. at the airport, at certain checkpoints they have. And, you know, they've been slowing down, you know, the back and forth from the mainland to the island because of certain cases that have been going through. We have a very high, over 70 years old people in the island. You know, we have a very high, a high amount of people, you know, that are, could be at risk. So, you know, people are trying to get, take care of that right now.
Yeah.
That's one of the main concerns, and people going out Sundays, we're not supposed to be out, just a few places open. You know, it's just that it's and it's going to be like that for a while because people just not understanding how to react to it. This is new for all of us.
Do you feel that this pandemic has made you more creative, and it has, you know, has it been good for you? Or would you say that you're going stir crazy and having little mental breakdowns like I am?
I'm gonna let them answer that, you know.
I think the mental breakdown are normal for now, but no. I, on the positive side, it's been an adventure, and as everything in life is just an adjustment. So it's been fine for us. It's been fine.
I think it makes us more patient, right? We have to be more patient now. Everything, everywhere you go, you're not going to find what you want 90% of the time. You have to stand in line. You can't get near people. I mean, it's like, it's made us more patient. Now, what do you guys see for Fantaville? What would be your like ultimate goal with this project?
Well, actually, we are working on our ultimate goal with this project. We are converting a Fantaville from TV series to a movie. So we are actually in the final stage of the script.
And that's fun.
some character design. There's some new characters coming on.
A new place. Gotta make a Kiki character.
I will.
I see you there. I see you.
You know, I'm gonna send it to a friend of mine at Disney, guys. I'm gonna send it to him this week. So pray. How many episodes do you have now of Fantaville?
We did the animatic for the until the fourth episode, but finished. We have the first episode and part of the second.
Okay. Awesome, yeah. Awesome. Okay, and so
we're looking for somebody who helps us out and we can sell it and help us finish the movie. And
I'm gonna give you my word. I'm gonna send it to Disney. That's all I can do. Okay.
Thank you, Kiki.
Thank you very much.
And tell me a little bit about what you have planned for the future, guys.
Well, for the future, we have two native projects coming up. One of them is called Slimies. It's about this very curious and adventure girl that loves to do slimes. And every day, she has a new adventure with them. So we also have a movie called Hotel Paraíso. Oh, and that's also on the script phase. And one more. It's the next step's coming up in November.
Behind the beauty. She is the brains behind the beauty.
Yes.
It's called Ese Pobre Lechon. And it's going to be a video game for mobile apps.
Is that like a video game about making lechon or something like that? Like, who can do it faster? Who can roast it faster?
Evade being a lechon.
Yes.
What are we going to do for Christmas, guys? Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's what you're gonna do. You're gonna play the Esper Lechon. That's
it's Lechon.
On the first day of Christmas, so it's after Thanksgiving. And it's a very cultural folklore Puerto Rican song that we turn into a game, and it's about the pig is running, but at the same time he's making music. So as far as you can go, the more instrument you can get, and the bigger and more fantastic than music.
Okay. Oh, good. And you actors, both of you, what are your plans? Do you have anything coming up that we could catch you in? Or is there anything going on right now? I know a lot of things aren't really in production.
Well, in my case, I keep working here. I have a podcast and I do my stuff on the internet, YouTube and stuff like that. And I still work here in TV. So most of the time, we're taping sketches or doing shows or on radio, because I, even though this pandemic, you know, I haven't stopped working. Thank God. Thank God.
Awesome.
Pretty soon, I have a improv group that is called Noches de Impro. And we're planning on doing a virtual show. So you can check us out over at Teatro Breve, either on Instagram or on Facebook. And there'll be info on that show, which will be digital. You can enjoy it from your home, and you'll see a lot of great improvisers there.
Listen, I was just talking to a comedian in New York for one of the projects that was selected. And she told me she sold 4,000 tickets, okay, for a virtual stand-up show. 4,000 tickets.
Wow.
So it's
you can't fit those people on a club.
I'm like, girl, I need to know what the hell you're doing.
You just got to do this, you know. We got to upgrade ourselves and understand how what's the flow of this place called the internet, because there's an audience for anything, you know.
Exactly.
You just gotta jump onto it. Like old actors, you know, actors have been for 30, 40 years, you know, they're learning to use their phones or videos, and, you know, they're uprising again. That's what we all gotta do, you know, upgrade ourselves.
Exactly. Like, I need my daughter to tell me to record when I'm doing my show.
You have the best teacher right there. You have the best teacher right there. She's going to upgrade you fast.
Oh, my God. Well, listen, guys, thank you so much for being here today and taking, you know, a beautiful day like this, taking part of Omnicultural TV Fest virtual pre-show. We're very excited to showcase Phantomville in our next event. And I wish you all well. Stay safe. And make sure you promote Omnicultural TV Fest when it comes your way, because we need to get everybody to watch and support all this beautiful diversity of talent that we have out there.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We're honored.
Thank you.
Love you guys.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you.
Love you guys. I thought that was pedo. Love you guys.
That's how Eric farts.
That's how he farts.